Hey everyone, this is Shannon's Review, and today I am here doing something different. I am going to be reviewing Married at First Sight. Actually, I'm not really reviewing it as much as I'm just giving my thoughts about the episode from, what was that, Wednesday, September 17th. I don't know which episode it was. I'll maybe put it at the bottom, but it was the one that literally just went off. So I'm not really going to go in any particular order here. I'm just going to say pretty much what I'm thinking. So yeah, let's just get into it here. And please feel free to comment down below if you guys want to, but please be respectful, okay? And no spamming or like any promotions. Okay, I would like to hear what you guys think about the latest episode as well. And I'm probably most likely not going to cover everything. I'm just going to be giving my thoughts. So I just want to start by saying, all right, let's see. Y'all, Morgan and Lindsay are crazy. Lindsay is crazy. And I'm just going to leave it there. It's something behind those eyes. Miguel, when she told Miguel that he has not really seen the worst of her crazy, I was like, oh my, OMG. You need to go. Miguel, you better run, because that is not cute. Telling somebody, oh, you haven't seen all of my crazy yet. Mm-mm. Nope. Nope, 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 nope. Okay. Anyway, moving on. Stassi and Nate. Stassi is a really pretty girl. She has a lot going for herself. Nice house, nice ride. She has money in the bank. She has a good career. And I love all of that about her. However, I feel that Stassi is like moving way too fast. Like, she needs to pump her brakes. Stassi's problem is that she treats all of her relationships, her past relationships, at least from what I see, as well as this marriage, she treats her relationships like fast food meals or like instant meals, like instant microwavable meals. She wants everything to be perfect within the next 2 to 3 minutes. And unfortunately, mama, relationships do not work like that, especially on Married at First Sight. Like, y'all don't even know each other. You guys are strangers. Pump your brakes, okay? I know you really want to be in love. You want to be married. You want to have kids. And I would say, just take your time. You'll get there. I would have to say, her and Nate, they went to the tattoo shop and they got matching tattoos. Why? People who get matching tattoos never make it. Hardly ever. Getting matching tattoos is like saying, this needs to be over and done, like right now, like 2 hours ago. Matching tattoos did not work. I don't mind couples going to get tattoos at the same time, but to get the exact same thing in the exact same place, it rarely ever works out. They may be together for a while, but then at some point they will break up. Matching tattoos is the kiss of death when it comes to relationships. All right, next. Let's go into Alexis. Like, again, these are just my thoughts as I was just watching along with the episodes. Alexis needs to stop telling Morgan stuff about Benji, about Ben. Like, she really needs to stop. I feel like if he's not dogging his wife out, then let that man vent to Justin. Justin is the only person in your household who is going through exactly the same thing that he's going through. Like, let the man speak. Just let him speak. Now, Ben should definitely be going to his wife and, you know, speaking about some things, or maybe his mom, or even maybe the experts, because we haven't seen the experts a lot. But production has them doing other things. That's my thought. Production has them casting for the next Married at First Sight instead of having them on the show like they used to have them a few years ago. I'm just looking at stuff. Anyway, like I said, I really don't know how Alexis is delivering the information to Morgan. It kind of feels like she's telling Morgan, like, girl, in my head, I'm imagining that Alexis is on the phone like, oh, girl, Morgan, let me tell you what Ben is up here talking about. He's saying this and that and da 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 da. Girl, he is up here dogging you out, telling all your business, yada, yada, yada. And it probably ain't even like that. But I'll come back to that. You know what? Instead of Alexis, like, getting so involved with Ben and Morgan's relationship, her and Justin need to be figuring out how they can get their two dogs to be living in the same house. And where's Justin's dog? I haven't seen that dog since they moved into the apartment. Excuse me, guys. And I don't know. Alexis kind of likes drama, like Justin said. Anyway, moving on. So, let's see. I already spoke about Lindy. I called her Lindsay in the beginning, but Lindy. Going back to Stassi and Nate, I just want to say, I feel like Nate is really just telling Stassi whatever she wants to hear at this point. She likes to be validated. Like I said, she likes her instant male relationships. Nate is telling Stassi whatever she wants to hear. Last week, she wasn't that happy when he gave her a 4 out of 10. Now he's like, oh, I love you. Bruh. Okay. Week 4 and you are in love and you're starting to love her, and she went from a 4 to a 7. It was all over Stassi's face. Stassi, you need to pump your brakes. I don't know what is going on with you. Like, you're looking for something and you're looking in the wrong places. The wrong man would definitely take advantage of you, and I actually think that's what happened. Like, because if a guy is just telling you whatever you want to hear, they're going to have your head going. Like, you need to pump your brakes, girl. But anyway, yes, Nate is just going along with the get along. Just telling Stassi what she wants to hear. So, next. I just want to say, when they were at the dinner party, everybody got to say what they wanted to say. And can we just give a round of applause for Kristen? And no, I did not spell her name right on my paper, but all I want to say is, Kristen, hello. Welcome to the room, honey. Welcome. I'm so glad she found her voice. And also, I really feel like her and Mitch are just two different people. She likes gas cars. He likes riding bikes. It is what it is. I don't know if they're going to make it. Okay, let's see. And next, let's go back over to Alexis. Yeah, Alexis is annoying. She's confusing. And I don't think her and Justin are gonna work out. I do not think that she and Justin is going to work out. Let me see. And let me just say this. Alexis, she does not want to be married to Justin. She does not want to be married to this man. Alexis is just in it until the 8 weeks, or she may even say yes on decision day, but I feel like they're not going to be together. I feel like Alexis is just doing it just to say, well, I did it. Like, I went along with the process, however it didn't work. Like, she's just in it to say she did it. I feel like when she swiped past him on that dating app, that was the last time she wanted to see him. And that's pretty much what she's doing right now. She's in the process. She's doing it because she's on the show. She doesn't want people to talk about her. She's doing it to do it, to be in the process. Once it's over, she's going to swipe him back to the curb. And Justin is like a people pleaser. He just likes to keep pleasing her. And I feel like he just walks on eggshells. So there's no reason for them to be in a relationship. Like, if you're going to walk on eggshells, he's so scared that if he does something wrong and then she blows up, like, then she's gone forever. Who want to be in a relationship like that? Chuck the deuces. Go. Please. Let's go back over to Nate. No. Ben and Morgan. Y'all saw how Morgan walked in that goddamn place, wherever they had their wedding and their honeymoon? She was walking like an angry fighter. Like an angry fighter. Like, I was scared for Ben. Morgan, why did you rip Ben open like that? I'm not saying that Ben, like, I don't know what Ben said, because they actually never said what Ben said. And when Ben was trying to when Ben was trying to explain what was going on or what he said to Justin, Morgan wouldn't let him speak. So I'm like, are we ever going to find out? Like, should we, like, we don't know whose side to be on. Like, should we be on Morgan's side or should we be on Ben's side? I mean, right now everybody's on Ben's side because Morgan just came in and ripped him a new one and she didn't let him speak. So we don't even know what was said. She didn't even let the guy defend himself. Or give a real explanation as to why he went to Justin. The guy said it was before. And my thing is that, do you think Alexis was snooping, or do you think Justin told Alexis what Ben told him? Because Morgan said, do you know that when you speak to Justin, he has you on speakerphone? So my thing is that, did Justin go back to Alexis, or did Alexis snoop on his phone call? And also, if she was snooping, maybe she just came at a time when he was just going off and venting and she didn't hear anything else. And then she took that information of what she heard and she went back and told Morgan. That's what I'm thinking. Morgan keeps saying that, oh, she's healed and I don't let this bother me. No, sis. Mm-mm. You're not. You have a lot of issues and you need to work it out. You need to go to anger management. And you're very controlling. You say that you're healed, but you are not. Not everybody need a little bit of therapy, but sis, you're not. Morgan needs to go to therapy. That wasn't cool. And why'd you throw those nice roses on the floor? Like, you could have just said, no, I don't want them. Keep them. Like, you taking them out his hand and then throwing it on the floor. Like, that was rude as hell. And the threat, like, I do not like the fact that she threatened him on camera. Like, girl, you told him that you was going to make him stay there and go through the process, and you're going to show him how much he hurt you every day. That sounded like a threat to me. At that point, I'd have been like, I gotta go. I would have told production, I'm leaving. I'm not even saying I'm not going back to the apartment. I'm going back to my personal apartment that I have been living in before I started this experiment, because that sounds like a threat and she needs to speak to the experts at this point. Okay? That's on that. And then also, going back to the table, when Alexis told Justin, it hurts. It still hurts. And then gets up and runs to the bathroom. Stassi runs to, like, to the bathroom with her. And my thing is, like, Alexis, girl, are you not doing the same thing that you was accusing Ben of doing with Justin with Stassi? Yeah, that's what I thought. That's what I thought. And also, I know they're shooting in California. And like I said, this is just my thoughts. It's just going to be random. You can agree to disagree, whatever. Where was they at? In Antarctica? Like, in Alaska? Was freezing. They had on full-blown down coats, like full-blown winter coats. Like, where were they? I'm not sitting outside in a cold doing those activities. Absolutely not. I went outside. I actually do not like to sit outside unless it's summertime, like at night. However, maybe about 2 years ago, I did go out to eat for my birthday, and we went in the tents, actually during the pee. I went out with a few friends, and we went to the spa. That was really nice. And then we went out to eat, and we was in a tent, and they had the little heat. It was not enough. Like, it was freezing, and I would never, ever do that again unless the heat is heating. Like, I need to be taking off my coat. But this one, where I went, it was cold as hell. My feet was freezing. I had to put my coat on. I had to put my scarf on. I had to order tea or hot chocolate. Like, no. If we gotta go sit outside in the winter, then I'm not going. No more. I need to be sitting inside. I need to be sitting inside. Where it's nice and warm or where it's nice and cool, depending on the season. Yeah, anyway, that's pretty much it. That was just my rant about what went on. Like I said, I didn't touch everything. But, I mean, those are just my thoughts on Married at First Sight episode. I don't know. I'll put it somewhere. Or I'll probably come back and say it somewhere, whatever. But yeah, that was my rant. Last thing, I do not think these couples are going to make it. Actually, I don't think any of them should stay together. And I don't be wishing no hate on anybody's relationship, but I don't think they need to stay together. Any of them at this point. It's not looking good. Ben, I'm gonna need you to stand up for yourself. Like, you're gonna have to stand up for yourself because you can't keep letting Morgan verbally abuse you and then she threatened you. So I really feel like you need to leave. Like, you need to pull an Alyssa, or not even Alyssa, who left? Well, whatever, you just need to bounce like Alyssa had to bounce last season. You need to get your Chris on. And you need to ask for that divorce now, because Morgan has issues. I actually feel like a lot of people have issues this season, and I feel like they need to do therapy. They should probably have more like therapy sessions with them before they actually agree to let them on the show, or just add in some therapy sessions. Like, get a new counselor, like a marriage counselor, and have them go to at least like 3 sessions throughout the season. I think that would help a lot more. And then also still have the experts sprinkled in. Like, the experts still should meet them after the honeymoon. They should still meet up with Dr. Pepper. Like, but I feel like they should have sessions, at least at least 2 to 3 sessions throughout the 8 weeks to see if this is really what they want. And also, one other thing, can you guys please, please stop signing up for this show and then saying I do to a stranger and praying and hoping that within the next 2 days or 7 days or 10 days or 15 or 30 or even 60 days. Please stop thinking that these people are supposed to say, oh my God, I love you. Oh my God, I'm falling in love with you. No. In any other relationship, that's usually not how it works in a regular relationship. I know you guys are moving a lot faster, but no. If your a partner doesn't tell you that they love you within the next 3 days, okay, fine. Fine. Why would you want to have somebody lie to you? At least they say, oh, I like you. I'm taking a real liking to you. Then that should be good enough in the beginning. Now, if we are like 6, 7, 12, 18 months down the road and then they still haven't loved you, say I love you, then you may need to rethink some things. But honestly, y'all need to chill. Ain't nobody going to be in love with you in 3 days. Stop. You didn't even know a person in 3 days. You don't even know a person in 3 months. Relax on the I love yous. They'll come when they come. You don't want to rush it. Trust me. They will come when they come. You want them to be genuine, not fake, like Nate. I feel like Nate's I love you or I'm falling in love with you is fake. Who wants that? I'd rather them say, I like you very much. I like you a lot. Or I'm starting to really like you more and more each day. Anyway, that's it. That's it. That's what I have to say about Married at First Sight. And give me 1 second. Hold on. Other phone is dead, so I can't look up the episode. But anyway, that's it. That's all I have to say about Married at First Sight. And I'm just uploading this video. I'm not editing anything. See ya.